As he fights out of the red corner, representing Brazil, it's Neiman Gracie.
Here in Abu Dhabi for Neiman Gracie. The fireworks are flowing. The smile on his face. Neiman Gracie is ecstatic to be here. We're ready to go here in this no-gi main event. A jiu-jitsu black belt, a representative of the Arch Suave, a member of the Gracie family, an active MMA fighter with a record of number submissions in his division, comes into the cage here, ATX1, in hopes of superior victory against the very tough opponent, Benson Henderson.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're proud to welcome you all to your main event of the evening, taking place here live from Abu Dhabi, UAE, for the historic inaugural of ADXC number one. Your main event of the evening is proudly sponsored by UAE JJ Fitness, Abu Dhabi Martial Arts Academy, ADNOC, Experience Abu Dhabi, and Abu Dhabi Sports, as well as International Vision Travels. Ladies and gentlemen, the stage is set. Your three judges being represented your cage side, Ben Cartridge, David Lefebvre, Tantoli Plested, and with the action begins, your referee in charge of the action, Mark Goddard. And now, reintroducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. He enters the cage tonight, 39 years old, standing at a height of 5'9", weighing in officially at 80.3 kgs. Here is an MMA pro fighter and a jiu-jitsu black belt. Ladies and gentlemen, his professional MMA record stands at 30 wins, with 8 of those big wins coming in by stoppage, by way of submission, presenting the former UFC and the former WEC lightweight champion of the world, fighting out of Arizona, USA, Benson Henderson. And now, introduces his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. He enters the cage tonight, 34 years old, standing at a height of 183 centimeters tall, weighing in officially at 84.1 kg. He too is a professional MMA fighter and a jiu-jitsu black belt. His professional MMA record stands 12 wins, with 9 of those wins coming to an early stop due to submission. Fighting out of Brazil, presenting Neiman Gracie. And with the cage door closes, your referee, Mark Goddard.
Well, this is it. This is the moment that we have been waiting for here at ADXC, our main event, the final match of the evening. Neiman Gracie in the red, up against Benson Henderson in the blue.
Really fast entrance here, like making Neiman on the spot. Henderson, that's a really, really good wrestler, and being very offensive on his MMA fights.
Look at the speed of Benson Henderson. You know, he has a little bit of a size disadvantage against Neiman. Neiman is naturally bigger, would compete at a weight class or two higher than Benson in MMA. They didn't weigh too far apart this week. It was 84 to about approximately 80 kilograms. But you look at the size difference, and Benson's much smaller, but I think that the speed is definitely a factor.
Opa.
But when that big man gets hold of you, that's the problem.
Exactly. You know, like if the fight goes to the ground, of course, that will be a good advantage for Neyman Gracie. You know, he's incredible on the ground, and Emerson is incredible on the takedowns and on the escape. So it's going to be a good scrap for sure. It's 2 minutes to the end of the first round here.
And I see that Neyman is kind of trying to push Benson up against the cage here.
Yeah.
And they're actually close to the red corner right in front of Neiman's family members, the one and only Henzo Gracie and Hobson Gracie right here. I mean, that's what happens. Whenever you see a member of the Gracie family fight, they bring the whole clan to kind of support each other, right? It's always been the way.
Yeah, it's representing the family. The jiu-jitsu in the world is their legacy, right? So it's always good to have a Gracie representative competing on the current era, you know, and then especially here at the ADXC is for the first time seeing Neyman already making in the main event. It's been a while since I saw Neyman compete in jiu-jitsu.
Yeah, a long time. Oh, flying attack there, but Benson pushes out and backs away.
It's 1 minute to go, probably part of the strategy. 1 minute down, let's go for this. Opa.
This is a 5 minute.
Let's go.
Sorry,
is that submission there?
Oh,
that's good defense there. By what a good attack there.
Benson from cartwheels out. This is a 5 round match. Each round will be 3 minutes with a 1 minute break.
Yes, Ben Hand is approachable, but with a lot of cautious.
Yeah, he doesn't want to go too deep into that guard and get tied up, right? That's the key thing for him here. His speed and his athleticism are crucial, and if he can jump past the guard like he's trying here, that's probably better than slowly trying to push your way through.
Yeah, he needs to go for some submissions, like maybe a good foot lock like that, you know what I mean?
Ooh, inside heel hook, look there.
That's well defended here by Elizon. Oops, very well slapped away.
And so while there was no pressure on the knee in that moment there, you have to say that the fact that he's initiating the attack, the fact that he's attempting, that's the kind of thing the judges are looking for here.
Yes, for sure. Well, that was quite interesting, right? Because you saw that there was Neyman doing a very good attack from the on the arm, and then straight away answered back.
Here it is.
That was on, you know.
Gets real pressure on the elbow.
Definitely a lot more than the heel hook possibility, you know.
But the control wasn't there to kind of allow that submission to come. It's more of a, I'm going to move you this way by forcing your limb, but Ben's not going to tap out to that.
No. The shoulder was kind of loose, and it could have kind of turned the head away.
But there is in the corner, next to Neyman Gracie, is the one and only Henzo. Always great to see Henzo here in Abu Dhabi. I mean, he's been coming here since the late 90s, of course. His relationship and his history with this place, stronger than maybe anybody in the jiu-jitsu world. Mark Goddard gets the second round underway here at ADXC 1 main event match. And there is a quick look
so
at the
fast
ankle pick from Benson Henson. We haven't really seen Neyman attempt any takedowns yet. He's used his size and his strength to kind of push Ben around a bit to try and get him against the fence, but he hasn't really shot or anything.
Yeah, I mean,
not yet.
Henderson, he's so good, or indicated, right? He used so well. He knows how he circles and everything. So now Neyman may as well try to bring the fight to what he's good at. Because I don't think he'd be able to take Benson down from the cage. He's too good at it. He's been there many times. It's a good approach here for the possibility of a
hit. Oh, yeah, that's nice work there from
well defended by
Neyman Gracie.
Benson.
Oh, we got a calf crush attack here. He's got that shin in the back, but uses it to expose Henderson rolling through.
So slippery, Henderson. Still good control.
But he's gone back into the calf crush attack here.
Position, yeah. To take the back now. And that's a good position here for Neyman Gracie on the leg drag attempt.
That was so cool from Neyman. He used the calf slicer not once but twice in that exchange.
He's
the first time.
Back.
Yeah, and I didn't think he would get it the second time, you know, that after Benson was able to roll out, but to insert that again. Now this is Neyman's first time on top in this match.
Yeah, looking forward to see how it's gonna develop. So already Benson is trying to get here a little bit. Opa, inverting triangle possibility here.
The difference being that Benson doesn't play guard, he wrestles up.
He's
going straight to his wrestling roots here.
That's a good position here for Neyman with a random cross face here. a lot of pressure, possibility to jump to the back or mount. 1 minute left. I was gonna
can't quite see if Nia, oh, he has almost like a cradle. Near side underhook. Now he's reaching over the back with a cross face.
Now Ben Henderson is holding for his life out there. Don't want to lose the arm at all. The leg, sorry. And that's a good position for Neymar if he's jumping over to the back.
Got
to
be careful. Yeah, he doesn't expose his back in this transition here. Big crossface there. Oh, huge crossface from Neiman Gracie.
30 seconds.
And that control of the near side leg with the hook.
Back control is going to be for the submission. It's going to be a really good choke.
Henderson over. Double hooks in. Seconds. Body triangle.
20 seconds.
Not a lot of time to work on that neck. He's definitely going to try.
Very slippery, Benson.
Henderson saying no. He's only got about 10 seconds in this match. Neiman can sink the attack in, but it's very difficult now. Completely flattened out from this body triangle position, but the clock is about to expire. There it is. End of the second round.
Well, definitely dominance from Benson, but at the same time, no enough time or gap for any kind of submission attempt. Real submission attempt. Let's check here on the replay. Second round, almost a submission from Neiman Gracie. Here we go. This was the triangle, right? Talk you through here.
Well, I just love the way that he used the calf slicer to make Ben go to his four-point position. But he rolled out, and he managed to do it again. And that was what really impressed me. But when he got the back, I mean, that was pretty close to a solid finishing position, right?
Yeah. No, for sure. It's like I'm enjoying a lot seeing the how Benson can move so smooth. Like, he doesn't let the full control to appear. And then when he's about to appear, he anchors himself in a way they cannot get out.
Third round of five scheduled rounds in this main event match. And there is the level change again from Henderson. He goes so quickly.
He's fast.
Oh, wow, that was a nice takedown.
Very fast.
Dropped into the ankle pick on the reaction, went up top and then kind of threw Gracie down.
Yeah, this time he went like, you know what? I already been engaging with him. Let's go for the ground.
Yeah, wasting no time.
Definitely winning this round.
So far, yeah, but we've still got over 2 minutes left. And look at the flexibility of Neiman. He brings the
very
right leg over.
Very flexible.
Like a no-gi lasso. And that's a good way of slowing your opponent down, right?
No. But he's very flexible.
What would you like to see Neiman do from this kind of position?
Exactly what I was doing right now. That's what I was going to say. Because it's working, so that's the triangle, the knee, to go to the back. With more time, right?
Okay, so here, what do you think is the attack here? Do you think he's going to go for the leg, or do you think he's going to make it
he
go for the back again?
He wants to go on top, probably. Like he wants to go on top. The knee's stuck there, but he can submit the guy there.
There is the calf slicer attempt. He's coming up and
that's
coming forward.
That's a submission attempt. That's a very good submission.
Oh, this looks really tight. This looks really, he's got the body lock. He's got the calf slicer locked in here.
This is real flexible, by the way. So I don't think he would tap on that specific submission. But now he got the top back attack here, possibly the triangle here.
Again.
He's been working a lot of these triangles here for a while.
Henderson's wrestling again, going straight to that sort of single head on the inside position. But once again, the back exposure is straight
to
the body triangle.
There's a lot more time now, eh?
This body triangle looking so tight, but I like how Henderson's staying calm. See the way that he's very aware.
He's so well controlled on his defense. He's been there many times. You know, Neiman trying to kind of have a good dominance here, but he cannot get the submission. The arm is there, maybe. He's so compact, no gap whatsoever.
Oh, you see the smothering there from Neiman briefly, hand over the mouth. it's a great way of disrupting your opponent's breathing.
Yeah, it's 15 seconds to go now. Probably gonna rest for the second round. Nima is doing well, but not enough to get the submission.
He hasn't cracked the shell. You know, he's
oh, here we go.
There was a not a bad attempt right at the end. I don't think he was really going for the submission, but just to show that, hey, I'm doing a rile here. But that was very interesting because the second round, that round ended just like the last. Third round ended just like the second. The back control, the body triangle, right?
Yeah, I mean, Nima is definitely dominated the whole fight, but let's see the replay here. Look, that's a good takedown from Benson. And he started really well, but then Nima got back the control, ended up on the back, but couldn't catch the submission yet. Well, he's dominating, and there's a few more rounds to go.
That body triangle is definitely a big factor so far in this match.
Twice now
that he's locked it in, and now in this fourth round, Nima just walking forward very calmly. I think he feels so confident. Imanari roll there from Benson Henderson. And I think Neiman's like, okay, you want to play? Let's play.
Yep.
No, wasting no time.
Now he has 2 minutes and 45 seconds to play in a very good position. But so far...
Oh, no choke, but still, that is over the face. You could get a submission via a neck crank here. He's looking for it. Trying to turn Henderson's head completely all the way around.
I'm very impressed with Benson's defense, you know, because it's not good to have like Neiman Grace on your back three times back to back, you know.
Oh, he's going down low. He was looking to try and catch the ankle there. Thought we may see a Suluev stretch for a second, but
he's tucked in the chin very deep, very hard to get underneath of that, you know. He's doing really well.
I mean, this is just experience, right? Ben's been here so many times.
Yeah, he knows what's going on, you know?
His hair is the trick.
Neiman saying his hair is the trick. That is making it harder for him to get in and to attack. So much hair in the way. Oh, but this is better. Look at this. Oh, the hand, though. The hand fighting from Henderson.
Now is a good position here for Neiman. Maybe to go for Amber. But he didn't. Happened there, but neither did
he. Just over halfway through this.
Benson is
round.
Shutting down everything here. Fending really well the first hand to get in. Using the shoulders, connecting the shoulders on the cheek, put the chin underneath. So it's very hard to get underneath of the neck.
You can hear Henderson.
Yeah, Henderson say if the worst case scenario. Mount and go to the armbar. If he falls on the mountain, get the armbar.
Right there. The legend himself, Henzo Gracie, coaching.
It's 50
Neiman.
Seconds. Well, the armbar attack would be the most effective way to open up that game right now.
There it is.
See that?
There it is. There it is.
He has attacked.
The armbar.
He's attacked. Wow. Wow. What
exactly
an amazing like, submission, man.
Exactly
wow.
Like Henzo Gracie was calling for. He said, armbar. Neiman said, you got it. He got the job done. Fourth round submission in our main event. And Neiman Gracie is the winner here at ADXC1. Great show of sportsmanship from Neiman Gracie with Ben Henderson right there. But that is the key to success. Listen to what Henzo tells you. The choke attack just wasn't quite finding the mark. But Neiman Gracie switching strategies, going for the arm, and was able to get the submission. There is the replay. Hips so high, bridging into that elbow. Absolutely nowhere to run, nowhere to roll, because the cage, of course, and Henzo's like, yes. Huge win right there for Neiman Gracie in this main event here at ADXC1. they share a few words after the match. All smiles, all respect between Neiman and Benson. Just appreciation, mutual appreciation, of course, in an event like this is key. Core values of the martial arts. And our referee, Mark Goddard, will bring the athletes to the center of the cage for the official results.
Ladies and gentlemen, your concluding bout and main event of the evening here at ADXC number one comes to a premature close with referee Mark Goddard calling a stop to the action at 2 minutes and 25 seconds in round number four, declaring your winner by submission via armbar to the red corner from Brazil, Neiman Gracie.
It's been a long time since I saw you competing in Jiu-Jitsu, and you came here all the way to Abu Dhabi in the first ADXC. What was the experience of being in the cage but not be able to use punches and kicks?
It was amazing. ADXC is the new show that's gonna take over grappling. So I'm very happy, and I hope to see you guys again. I wanna fight another MMA legend in December maybe. So in the next show, I'll be here again.
He's talking about the fight, fighting the legend, Ben Henderson. And were you surprised with his defenses? Because you got to the back many times, and then, but you never had enough time.
Ben is the man. He's a huge fan. So he's the man. I think the trick is on his hair. So you cannot get his neck. There's no way you can mata leon that guy.
So I heard a lot of Henzo, go to the arm, go to the mount, attack the arms, the time is running out. What goes through your mind on that time?
Whatever the master tells me, I have to do it. Otherwise, he's gonna kick my butt in the backstage.
Ladies and gentlemen, Neiman Gracie, congratulations, my man.
What an end to the show here at ADXC1. Neiman Gracie defeating Benson Henderson via armbar in the fourth round. A very hard-fought match in which Neiman did his best to find the submission, multiple attacks, but in the end, it really came down to listening to his coach, his mentor, the legend, Henzo Gracie, and switching strategies and going for the armbar. And that was it. Enzo, a legend of Jiu-Jitsu, probably has the strongest relationship with Abu Dhabi of any Jiu-Jitsu practitioner in the world. As that ADCC champion has been coming to Abu Dhabi and training with members of the royal family, and has inspired people so much for so long. Great to see him here at the cage. And here is a look at that final armbar. Going straight from the back control, so quick onto the arm, bridging the hips up high. And Henderson, absolutely nowhere to go, rolling forward, but running out of space with the cage there. And Henzo, obviously very, very happy with that result. Once again, Gracie Jiu-Jitsu takes the win here in Abu Dhabi. Well, that's it from...